performing with us today. Joel and Sheila. Joel is recovering from Covete right now. He got, yeah, so.
He's addicted to the panini.
The panini got it. So they're with us in spirit, and please enjoy the show. Thank you.
Yeah. So, up first, we have the man with the plan, the maestro of the keys. Would you like to take the rest?
The bench on the bench. Everyone, please put your hands together for Lloyd.
Thank you, Justin. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this song has very special meaning. If you go back, well, first of all, this song was sung and made famous by, how shall we say, Old Blue Eyes. And at the time he sang it, he didn't know how important it would become. But soon, right after 9/11, this song made a whole big following. And I was working at a hospital in Brooklyn, and they asked me to be part of a group that would try to lift the spirits of all the workers in the hospital. And I did this song. That's life. That's what they say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. I know I'm gonna change that tune. When I'm back on top in June, I say that's life. And funny as it seems, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I know I don't let it get me down. For this old world keeps spinning around. I've been a puppet, a power, a pirate, a poet, a pawn and a king. I've been up and down and over and out, and I know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. I can't tell you, I can't deny it. I'm gonna quit, baby. But my heart just ain't gonna buy it. And if I didn't think it was worth one single try, I jump right on that big bird and then I fly. I've been a puppet, a pirate, a poet, a pauper, a pawn and a key. I've been up and down and over and out, and you know one thing. Each time I find myself flat on my face, I pick myself up and get back in the race. That's life. And I can't deny it. Many times I'm gonna quit, but my heart just won't buy it. And I don't think it was worth one more try. I jump on a big bird and then I fly.
Are going to share a song of eternal love with you all.
So, Joyce, I want to tell you about how I first learned about love. The first time I learned about love was from my parents. And when I was a child, they grew roses about a year or two before my father passed away. And those roses still grow today. And I carry their love with me. And I believe in love because of them. so I'm going to sing a song inspired by them. I thought that love was just a word they sang about in songs I heard.
With the movie. And my wish was I wanted to go to acting school. I begged my mother, and she says, no, we can't afford it. Finally, one day when I was 11 years old, my mother said, guess what? I'm going to send you to acting school. So she sent me for a three-month program at the American Academy of Dramatic Arts Acting School for Children. I was so excited, I couldn't believe it. I took creative dramatics, speech, and movement. And I thought I was so great. I really thought I was the next Shirley Temple, but no one else told me that. Anyway, I made a lot of friends. I had a lot of kids my age there, and I had a really, really amazing time. When it came time for the end of the 3 months, and my mother went to renew my tuition for the next session, the head of the American Academy of Dramatic Arts Children's Acting School told my mother, don't waste your money, she has no talent. This is the God's truth. Anyway, I was devastated, of course, as any kid would be, but I swore to myself, I'm gonna prove that they are wrong. I have some kind of talent. Anyway, I got a little older, I went to high school. I got very caught up in the Beatles and Beatlemania and the British Invasion. I formed my own female all-girl rock and roll band. I had a friend with whom I wrote a lot of songs. We used to schlep up to the record companies every day after school and peddle the songs. We actually got a contract for a couple of them, but they wanted us to do something, you know, help them arrange the songs, quote unquote. And there was one guy who said, okay, why don't you two come to my apartment, we'll help arrange the songs. We said, okay. And he says, oh no, not both of you. I only want one, and it doesn't matter which one. So we knew what was up. So we decided we were not going to sell out and, you know, sleep our way at the top. So we went back to being high school kids. Later on, I decided to become a teacher. And if you think about it, teaching is very, very similar to acting because you are performing in front of a live audience every single day. And I thought that was really cool. So as life went on, I fell in love, got married, became a mother, became a grandmother. And everything was pretty normal, and that was it. Anyway, when my husband passed away, I joined the CLLD. And I also joined the Senior Boomers Ensemble, which was one of the best things I ever did. Nobody told me I was terrible. Nobody said I had no talent. And I was actually encouraged to sing in public for the first time in over 50 years. This is my seventh show that I'm doing, and I just love it. And as far as singing in public, well, guess what? I'm going to do it again right now. If you don't like my voice, please feel free to lower your hearing aids. Here I go. I mean, the two songs that really hit home with me. My backup singer, they need you. Thank you.
You got it.
I know I'll always get by.
not a bite left to give. Hit it!
Show.
So I'd like to sing Can't Help Loving That Man for you. Hey, listen, sister. I'm loving my Mr. Man, and I can't tell you why.
Why I ain't going to the gym yet?
There ain't no reason why I should not.
Feelings that are in our minds and in our everybody's in shape.
Like poetry.
Walk around and bicycle.
That brings those feelings out into words.
No words. Oh, yes. I agree. Yeah.
You can tell the love of the music and the words in our fine performers here today. And so many of the days that we have here. As for me, like you, I'm sure,
are you taking
there have been many dark days. And music is what helped me get through those challenges. That's why I'm going to attempt to sing a song based on the music of Johann Jasabel of the 18th century, canon in D major. It has become so universally popular that besides weddings and funerals, we have a current pop singer, Adam Levine, who is the lead of Maroon 5 on the top 40 charts today. So as they stole from each other, I have stolen their music, and I have put words to my memories. Here's to the memories we got. Here's to the wish they were still here. But they're not. But our shows bring back those memories of everything we've been through. And now I hope to bring some of those memories back to you. There was a time that I remember when we did not know pandemic pain, when we had such good times here and the news was not so insane. Everybody has had hurt sometime. Everybody wants things to stay the same. But things have always changed at times. So let's raise a glass and say, it's not our fault. Here's to all of the CLL G classes we still get. Here's to all the good learning and people we've met. Yes, the drinks bring back the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the lunch we get by way. So the drinks bring back those memories. And the memories bring back happiness too. Here's
glass that I never went to. But the dreams bring back the memories of what I wanted to do. But the dreams also bring back memories that I'm still dancing to. So here's to everyone here, everyone who has brought us so much cheer. And let's toast this CLLT for still being here to bring back the memories of all the things we have yet to do.
From one beacon of authenticity to another, I would like to welcome my co-host, Justin, to sing his song for a short message of self-acceptance, love, and being fiercely yourself.
Hi. So I find it funny that you say authenticity because I still struggle with finding my authentic self. I've gotten to work with these amazing seniors for now 3 years creating shows. And something I learn from them every year is being unapologetically themselves. They don't care what anybody thinks. So that weirdo up there doing junior year Edwardian theater turned into that. But who are they? I still struggle with self-doubt, with feelings of, am I good enough? And then I come to class every week, and I hear their beautiful stories, and I hear them speak their truth. And it makes me think, I am what I am.
Mine.
Snapshot Memory Cafe. We like to leave you all with an oldie but a goodie. However, we do have one rule before we go. You gotta sing along. So here is Those Were the Days.
Once upon a time, there was a tavern where we used to raise a glass or two. Remember how we laughed away the hours and think of all the great things we would do, everybody. Starry notions on the way. If by chance you see you in the tavern, we smile at one another and we say, those were the days, my friend. We fought together and we sing and dance forever and a day. We live the life.
Whenever I go, everyone is saying, I will leave. And I think Arlene gets the same. Probably we've been sisters in previous life, but what we share, love for you, love for music. But love for you is the most important thing. CLL gives here for 10 years. I don't know, I didn't count how many years we have Illuminar with us, but just four. But just today I said, I don't care whether Arlene will get funding or not. Senior boomers are staying forever. You're amazing. You know, I'm looking at you, I'm looking at Lloyd, I'm looking at everyone, and you know, even when I'm so tired, I'm looking at you, and you fill up me with life, with happiness, every one of you. I mean it. You are the best. You bring life, you bring joy, you bring happiness. We survived COVID because of you, and we'll survive everyone. We won't just survive. We will live. We will boom. I love you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Arlene, for bringing this beautiful program to us. Thank you, Arlene. I mean it. Thank you, Kit. I just saw Ariel. She so regrets that she can't be here. She's at this conference. I don't know. She's wasting her time there. She should be here. But she's here. Her heart. Thank you, Jenny. Thank you, Justin. Thank you, Lloyd. My talented, talented Lloyd. During COVID, how many lives he saved with weekly classes? My super talented Joyce. Every one of you, you're my life, really. So thank you so much. Thank you, you're the best.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do one more song because you asked for it. There was this this Jewish boy from Brooklyn, and he decided he wanted to write music, and he wrote many, many songs. He wrote the show on Broadway called Harmony, so everyone must sing along to this song. Here we go. Here we go. You know I can't smile without you. I can't smile without you. I can't laugh and I can't sing. I find it hard to do anything because I feel my day. Who would believe that you were part of that dream? Now it all seems light years away. You know I can't smile without you. I can't smile without you. I can't laugh and I can't sing. I'll find it hard to do anything. So many you.
Thank you all so much for being a lovely audience. I want to thank the lovely Mona. Please take a bow. Yeah. Darlene, you rock. Thank you so much. Joyce, you beautiful soul, thank you. Justin, it's been amazing work for you. Please, everyone, give a huge round of applause to Mr. Roy, the musical director, the bench on the bench, the man with the plan. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, those three over there, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Bella, thank you so much. Jenna in the back, from all the JCC staff, thank you. Thank you.
It's my turn to thank all of the wonderful people who have made this possible for us. Let's all give them a round of applause. The senior boomers would not exist without these fine people. I am here to thank Jenny and Justin. They are teaching artists because they have taught us not everything we know, but everything about theater that has made this possible. So Jenny, Justin, thank you.
Yeah. Don't problem I have here. I'm sorry. I can't get anybody.
I'm sure Arlene wants to take a picture. So, but thank you all so much. That's all, folks.